Greetings, everyone. This is Rock and Roll Spot Connection with another installment of Mutant Monday. And today, we're looking at some theories that have come to mind of late, reading through recent X-Men comics. So first off, here's the fact that we have three separate anti-mutant groups throughout the Dawn of X line. We've got Orcus, Hominis Verendi, and Xenos. So, what I'm kind of starting to lean towards is eventually these three groups are going to team up. And there's a distinct possibility that horticulture might at least help them, at least at the very least in an unwitting manner. By basically having intelligence on Krakoan tech and how it works, how it can maybe it not work, so on and so forth. So the three that will I definitely see teaming up in the future, Orcus. What do they bring to the table? Tech and manpower. Professional manpower, in that case. We're talking, Orcus, after all, consists of people from organizations such as S.H.I.E.L.D., AIM, Hammer, Hydra, Strike. So yeah, you've got a lot of highly trained people. And some just at least, you have people that are at the very least moderately trained. Next up, Hominis Verendi. Money. It's a bunch of rich kids. I mean that literally, they are children. I figured right now, this one, they're probably teenagers, but yeah. They're rich teenagers. They have money. Money to fund groups like Orcus or Xeno. And then we got Xeno. Xeno, one, clearly brings manpower to the table. They've also got a lot of underworld ties, or not so much underworld, so much as just shadowy ties to more shadowy groups, such as Weapon X, presumably the Church of Humanity, the Sapien League. Possibly also the Reavers, and so on and so forth. But, and that's the other thing also with them is that some of the groups that they have ties to also have got utilized fronts, basically. The kind of thing where they, like, perhaps churches where the pastor says not too controversial anti-mutant things,
someone close to you was injured in a mutant-related incident. Well, I can put you in touch with people that know that can help you deal with this, and they can help your friend deal with this. And so that person that gets pushed along the journey towards radicalization that begins. So yeah, you've basically grassroots support and the potential for also additional recruitment. Next up, Rogue and Apocalypse. So at the end of Excalibur number 5 from this past week, Rogue seemingly killed Apocalypse with her power draining abilities. And apparently this was also all according to Apocalypse's plan. From what he says, it was all part of the plan. Now, it's also revealed that part of his plan, his plan's endgame was conquering other worlds, deposing Morgan Le Fay, so on and so forth. So, long-term thought on this is that we're probably, at the very least, I see Rogue having a spike in her power levels. And maybe through the combination of, you know, Apocalypse's power, both mutant and celestial abilities, or the celestial modification of his abilities, we might end up seeing Rogue develop a greater degree of control over her natural abilities. But it'll be nice to see Rogue even more powerful. However, I think it's pretty clear that any time a member of an X team dies, they're gonna be reborn. And quickly. I'd be surprised if we hit Excalibur number 12 without Apocalypse being resurrected. Now we got some smaller things. First off, the lack of precogs on Krakoa. So, as was shown in Powers of Ten number 6, there is a strict no precogs policy on Krakoa, because precogs could potentially see that mutant kind is still going to lose. And that would be it. This kind of thing would spread. If a precog were to see, oh, damn, we lose, and we lose bad, then it spreads to the rest of the island, and a lot of people are then like, then why are we just partying all the time? We should be making sure we don't lose. And we know that soon in X-Men, Mystique is going to make a point of... Mystique is going to try and force Charles and Magneto's hand and force the resurrection of Destiny. So yeah, pretty sure that at least the no precogs rule will be discovered. Possibly also Moira's presence on Krakoa. And that's going to be one of the major, I think that'll end up being one of the major blow-up points. Now, this next one I'm basing on how Jonathan Hickman's Avengers run ended. Jonathan Hickman's run of Avengers, well, actually how it began and how it ended. It began with the Avengers starting with the big three, Captain America, Thor, and Iron Man, coming together to reform the Avengers. Or to rebuild the Avengers, at least. And it ended with Cap and Iron Man at each other's throats. And I think that we're probably going to see something similar, but with Xavier and Magneto. That's probably how we're looking at for an ending. And I figured the Hickman era is probably going to last a good... I'm going to guess at least 5 years. So far, we've already got... Apparently, Hickman already has 3 years' worth of stories plotted out. At least, I presume that... What I presume to be... Being he's got the bare bones of the story, and he's just going to go from there. And there's probably even a... Okay, yeah, here's the vague roadmap. Make sure your stories don't... Make sure the stuff you're writing doesn't cause anything on this to diverge too terribly much. Another theory, and this is already something that's proving to be true, but I think we're going to see a lot more characters who are traditionally X-Men villains as members of X-related teams. And I said this is already being confirmed as there's a new Hellions book coming out in... I want to say March, and the lineup features Empath from the Hellions and John Graycrow, or Scalp Hunter as he has been known in the past, from Mr. Sinister's Marauders team lineup, and they're going to be on a team with among others Psylocke, Quinnon, and Havoc, as well as Wildchild, various others. So yeah, I think we'll be seeing a lot more, like I said, previously traditionally villainous X-Men characters working on the side of good. And finally, and this is more kind of just conjecture based on that little vignette from Incoming. Sinister is going to cause problems, most likely with clones, because, well, that's kind of on brand for Sinister, is causing problems with clones. Anyway, that's it for now. As always, feel free to like, share, and subscribe. Links to my Facebook, Twitter, Patreon, and PayPal can be found in the description box down below. This is Rock and Roll Spock signing off, saying, live long and rock hard.